155, to terminate the services of Mary Ann G. Pitts as the council liaison for the city of Richmond. Resolution number 2012-R156, to terminate the services of Francine B. Young as a council liaison for the city of Richmond. And resolution number 2012-R157, to terminate the services of Eli A. Wong as a council liaison for the city of Richmond. I will need a motion for expedited consideration of those three papers as presented. Ms. Newman, will you make that motion?
So moved, Madam Clerk.
Council is voting on Councilwoman Newbill's motion for expedited consideration of those three papers. Resolution 2012-R155, R156, and R157, as written. Mr. Connor?
Aye.
Mr. Samuels?
Aye.
Vice President Robinson?
Aye.
Mr. Jewell?
Aye.
Ms. Newbill?
Aye.
Ms. Trimble?
Aye.
Mr. Tyler?
No.
President Gravianna?
Aye.
Those papers are before you for consideration.
Thank you. Is there anyone in the audience who wishes to speak in opposition to any of these papers?
My name is Chris Dorsey. I want to speak in opposition to the papers. Relieving, I guess, the council liaison from duty. First of all, in the first district, I don't think that there's been a clear result of a winner. I'm not sure why the sitting council member is having their liaison removed. I have presented evidence that has been covered up by city officials, that has been presented to Mr. DeLong, who's the city auditor, showing that Mr. Belisles did not even properly qualify to be on the ballot, and there's been multiple court cases showing that the registrar violated Virginia Code Section 2.2. And those are Epps versus Showalter and Ryan versus Showalter. And we have a case, Harvey versus Showalter, where we show not, you know, every council liaison that's being considered to be removed, that there were so many anomalies and violations of state and federal law that the elections are completely invalid. For example, in the ninth district, there was an entire precinct that didn't report at all by the deadline. Meaning precinct 910 reported zero votes by the deadline, and that's because of no explanation given. But, and that, you know, in the fifth district, it's been shown that Parker Aguilesto did not properly qualify for the ballot. And that somehow the registrar, Kurt Showalter, just pushed it along. And Section 2.2, I like Marty, but Marty didn't qualify because Marty had so many outstanding debts to pay that he couldn't properly run. So all these things have been presented to a federal judge and to other judges. Actually, there have been four judges that have been looking into what's leading up to getting rid of all of these council liaisons. And what people see is that the state board and the Richmond registrar and the electoral board, they didn't do anything that they were supposed to do. They didn't follow the law at all when it comes to the elections. And we really can't have a proper election when there's so many anomalies and people who don't belong in the ballot. Mr. Gallagher, he doesn't belong in the ballot. He put down two different addresses on his petition ballots. That's a violation of the rules. But everyone did this. I'm just saying, what I'm saying is, the election is fraudulent. I'm speaking on a paper in which a council liaison is about to be dismissed, and there isn't really a properly clarified winner because of all these anomalies and violations of law engaged in by council and Alan Jackson and Showalter and the Richmond electoral board, Cecilia Dabney, you know, Bill Thomas, etc. I mean, that's it. That's it. People look into it. It's the law. The elections are a fraud.
Thank you.
There's only one thing I would agree with what Chris just said. And District 1.
Correct.
How come Mary Ann, when
Mr. Jackson, how about Mr. Jackson answer?
I don't think I asked that question, so.
Madam President, at this point, the status of the elections, I understand it is that the elected board has published a statement of results. It is subject to both a recount petition as well as a potential contest. It is expected that those proceedings will be concluded before the effective date of these terminations, such that at council's organizational meeting on January 23rd, January 2nd, if appropriate, any one or more of these could be repealed and the employment of the individuals continue.
So you're saying that even though this is titled in the courts right now, who's to say it's not going to go to a higher court or whatever? Who's to say we're going to even know who the winner is, per se, by the 2nd of January? So that what I'm asking, why do we have, you know, her name on here for the first district when this thing is still coming to the courts? And you know, I don't know if you know something that we don't know as far as why this her name cannot be removed from the paper.
I can only speak to the...
I can't hear you, Alan.
I'm sorry. I can only speak to the status of the legal proceedings at this point, Mr. Campbell. With respect to the recount petition, which is scheduled to be heard on December 19th, it's my understanding that there is no appeal from the decision of the court. In terms of the contest, what I understand is that the proceedings there are entitled to highly expedited review, and I would expect that those proceedings, the hearing on those proceedings would be set, in the words of the statute, as soon as possible. And I would expect that to happen before January 1, which is when the term of office is supposed to begin. It hasn't been done yet, but that's the expectation. As I indicated earlier, if council wishes to take alternative action on January 2nd, it will be free to do so.
Which means if the recount changes the outcome, or if the contested, Mr. Tyler has contested the election, if the courts determine that Mr. Tyler should be sitting in that seat on January 2nd, we're going to have a meeting for our reorganization and to get sworn in. At that time, this paper can be removed. Ms. Pitts will just go on her way just the way she is. But because we're going to change this so this doesn't happen again, because all of council appoints liaisons, then all of council, when a sitting member is no longer in that seat, and that all council has to, in effect, terminate that liaison. That's the way our rules are written. We're going to try to change some of that so we don't get ourselves in this position again.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
I'll understand procedurally what's going on here. What Mr. Dorsey had to say, much of it was a bunch of hooey. But one thing did resonate with me, and I think we all have to come to terms with, and that is that this was the sloppiest handling of an election I've ever seen in my life. And that we will have to, if this council doesn't, certainly the citizens may, raise this issue with regards to not only what happened, but the when. And the fact that I don't know an agency in state or city government in which there is no appeal. I've never seen that before. We've got an electoral board that appeared and been run by the registrar. And this is not to disparage you personally, but I've just never, I've been hopelessly political all my life. I've just never cases wound up being reversed, suggesting that they were totally out of order. And so we need to look at this, and I commend it to this council going forward that perhaps you may address it going down the road real soon.
Thank you, Mr. Jewell. Back to public comment. Is there anyone in the audience to speak in favor of any of these papers? Back to council for discussion. Call the question, Madam Clerk.
Council is voting on resolution number 2012-R155, R156, and R157. Mr. Connor?
Aye.
Mr. Samuels?
Aye.
Mr. Gilbert?
Aye.
Sorry. Vice President Robinson?
Aye.
Mr. Jewell?
Aye.
Ms. Newville?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
No for Ms. Pitts, and aye for the other two.
Mr. Tyler?
No for Mrs. Pitts, and aye for the other two.
Ms. Nicasio?
Aye.
Ms. Peters have been adopted.
Okay, this time we have approval of the minutes.
The minutes to be approved are from the November 26, 2012 informal meeting, the November 26, 2012 formal meeting, and the December 3rd, 2012 special meetings. Mr. Connor, would you be willing to make a motion to approve these minutes?
So moved, Madam Clerk.
Council is voting on Council Member Connor's motion to approve the minutes as presented. Mr. Connor?
Aye.
Mr. Samuels?
Aye.
Madam Vice President Robertson?
Aye.
Mr. Jewell?
Aye.
Ms. Newville?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Mr. Tyler?
Aye.
Madam President Graziano?
Aye.
Motion has been approved.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. Before we go to reports and announcements, I'd like to just point out a couple of things, both to my fellow council members and to the public. In the introduction papers today, we have a second paper coming in that deals with the Redskin Bonds of Course ordinance, it's an amendment to that.